You know, Grothendieck-Galois theory, Grothendieck introduced Galois theory in this GA1 as a characterization of the category of actions of a profinite group on sets. Okay? And Tanaka, Tanaka Deligne work was, yes. Excuse me? It's not working. Well, I don't know. I just don't talk too loud. What's the problem?
Yes, it is on. It is on, but.
Well, I can. Well, anyway, that doesn't help you to talk about it. So, and Tanaka is a characterization, neutral Tanaka. We are going to talk today about neutral Tanaka. It's a characterization of the category of comodules on a Hopf algebra. Okay? So, now, Tanaka has been generalized from vector space to tensor monoidal closed categories. The statements of Tanaka has been generalized, but not the proof of the theorems, okay? And Galois, Grothendieck-Galois, has been generalized from profinite groups to locally groups, okay? Now, if you see that a locally group is the same thing that the Hopf algebra in the category of sublattices. So we have the machinery of Tanaka for the category of sublattices, and we are, in Tanaka will characterize the comodules on the Hopf algebra, but in the category of sublattices. And Hopf algebra is the same thing that the locally group, so we can imagine that we can compare. And what we prove, and we are going to talk today, is the equivalence of the Tanaka recognition theorem for in the category of sublattices with the characterization of atomic topoi, pointed atomic topoi on the Galois side. Okay. Now, before I start, I will would like to make, we are going to make a little survey of what is locally Galois theory and what is the Tanaka theory, and then we'll more or less indicate a little bit how we can go through the proof of the statements. Now, before that, I would like to make something which is very, a little survey of Galois theory, which is very basic for this audience, but I would like to make it anyway. So we have, see, in the category of sets, a functor, which is the inverse, C is a site, let's say locally connected atomic site, and F is the inverse image of a point. And then we can make this picture. Here we have F. Here this is the category of elements of the functor F, which is contained in ants to the C up. Okay, so this lives in the dual category of functors. F belongs there. Now, an element X here, if X is in f of x is the same thing that you have. This is the covariant functor on x, and so we have a natural transformation into f, but since we are in the dual category, we have an arrow like that. And then we have another y, and then since f preserves finite limits, we can see that this category is co-filtered. Meaning that given two objects, there is one z which is closer to f. Okay. Now, this co-filteredness of the category gamma f follows because f preserves finite limits. Now, how we interpret Galois closure? You have a here. And we are going to see how we can cover x by a Galois object. The Galois object is just a torsor for the automorphism of A, acts in A, and we ask this action to be like a torsor. Okay? This is a Galois object. Now, if every x is covered by a Galois object, means that the Galois objects are cofinal in the diagram that gives f. The inverse limit of the whole category is f. Okay? Now, if I take the product of as many times of x as there are elements in f of x, and this product exists and is preserved by f, this is a cotensor of x with the set f of x. If f preserves this cotensor, then this product lives inside the category gamma f by the same reason that if f preserves a finite limit z, which is the product of x and y, lives there. So if we put the action on the point, stronger preservation actions, not only finite limits, but also cotensors with sets, well, by definition of cotensor, so then we have a Galois closure. Now, if we have Galois closure, f is the colimit, or I mean the inverse limit in dual category, only on the subcategory of Galois objects. Okay? One important property of Galois objects is that if you have a map between two Galois objects, then it defines a morphism of groups from the automorphisms of A and the automorphisms of B. Okay? Now, for example, the original Grothendieck axioms on the category C just say, well, that this is is an atomic site of connected objects. These are explicitly said in SGA1, not with this language, but the statement means that. And that f of x is finite for every x. So if f of x is finite, then Galois closure exists, because this is a finite product, and f preserves finite limits. And so you take the inverse limit of these finite groups, and this is the profinite group that, and then Grothendieck shows that C is equivalent to the category of transitive actions, which are the connected objects of these profinite groups in sets. Okay. Now, in SGA4, we can generalize. We don't say that f of x is finite, but we put this stronger condition of preservation on f, and then we still have a Galois closure. And then we can still think in the inverse limit on the inverse limit of all these groups on the Galois objects. Now, in the finite case, if all these groups are finite, then an old result of Bourbaki shows that this Evers limit is not empty, and the projections are surjective, and that's why the thing works. Now, in SGA4, Grothendieck has to take this indexed by A is a progroup. So in SGA4, Grothendieck works with this progroup, because there is no longer the case that this inverse limit exists or is very empty. Okay. So he has the progroup, and he defines what is an action of a progroup in a set, and then he shows the theorem in which C becomes the transitive actions of a progroup on a set. But then it came the work on locales. Then if we take this inverse limit in the category of localic groups, okay, then it doesn't lose his points. But it loses his points, but it's a non-trivial localic group. And then we have the theorem for this localic group. So instead of having a progroup, we can go with localic group. But this is a pro-discrete localic group, inverse limit in the category of localic groups of discrete groups. So with the hypothesis of existence of Galois closure, which is, means that the preservation of these cotensors by F. But then, if we don't use that hypothesis, we have only a point which preserves finite limits. And so we have to be able to define which will be the local of automorphism, the localic group of automorphisms of F, and show the theorem. Okay, this theorem came out in the first who proved the theorem for localic groups and atomic topoi was Joyal and Joyal Tierney. But there are two or three out of the hat Joyal ideas that produce the theorem. But then I say, well, I want to prove the theorem just by hand. Okay? Because you see, if the inverse limit of the whole category exists, then means that the factor F is representable by the inverse limit. And so we are in the case of a representable. And the case of a representable is Galois theory. I mean, just finite extensions and intermediate extensions. So if we look at the theorem in the representable case, then I say, well, I will try to imitate the proof in this for the automorphisms of F, thinking F as being an object E, I mean, being able to define the locally group of automorphisms of F, okay? And so this gives the end of the generalizations using locally groups. So, Control L. So this is what I just talked with that picture, okay? This is the Galois evolution, the evolution of Galois theory. Galois, if the functor F is representable, then finite set valued is SGA1, F preserved cotensors is SGA4, and then we have Galois, locally Galois theory, which is my work for the theorem. And the theorem says that the comparison functor is an equivalence. So, now, Tanaka theory, general Tanaka theory, we have a co-complete monoidal closed category, and V0 are the objects which have a right dual. The theorem look at here is the example, the Deligne theorem, is the example where V is vector spaces and V0 are finite dimensional vector spaces, which have dual. So you take the co-module. Well, then, having this situation, in general, you can define the end nu of t, which is the, a Hopf algebra of natural transformations pre-dual of natural transformation from t to t, which is defined as that Cohen. Why Joyal called this, and then he wrote the paper with Rostrit, he called this a pre-dual, because if we take the classical dual, which is there, which is, no, ah, there, which is there with a star, we need the morphisms into the identity objects in the closed category. Then by the coin goes up, as goes out as an end, and then you get the formula of classical formula of natural transformations as an end. So if we take the morphism into the neutral object of the tensor product, which are the points in a sense of this pre-dual, then we get the natural transformations. But this this object may not have any points. Okay. So we have H is this coin. This is just the Lin Tanaka theory done in an arbitrary complete monoidal category. Now, if H is H is always a coalgebra, and then there is a lifting from A into the comodules, because this there is always a comodule structure from TOX and this coalgebra H. And now T, you see, T takes the value in the category of objects with dual. Now, if A is monoidal itself, then H is a bialgebra, meaning it will have this coalgebra also has a product, it's an algebra. When A is symmetric, H is commutative algebra. If the objects of A have duals, then A is a Hopf algebra. So in alternative terminology, A is a rigid symmetric tensor. If A is rigid symmetric tensor, then this pre-dual, Joyal pre-dual, is a Hopf algebra. And we have the category of comodules over H, and we wonder when this lifting is an equivalence. Okay? So this is just the Tanaka. Now we are, as I said, we work on the closed category of sublattices, SL. Then a locale is just an idempotent algebra there, by the very definition, in which the product is the infimum. That's why it's an idempotent algebra. And a locally group is a group object in the dual category of sublattices, meaning that it will have a coalgebra structure, because it's a dual, it goes in the other direction. And it can be seen that a locally group is exactly the same thing than an idempotent of Hopf algebra on sublattices. Now, if X is a set, then L of X is the power set, the notation for the power set, with the direct image. And it's the free sublattice on X. You see there, okay. There you have a relation from X to Y, and then the direct image from the power set of X and the power set of Y defines a linear map. Linear map, so I use the terms of linear algebra. Linear map is just a sublattice morphism, preserve only subs. That we call linear map. So the direct image generalizes to relations and gives this correspondence. So we have the category of sets that now is called S, into the category of sets with relations as arrows, and then we have L, which is the power set, and this is full and faithful, meaning a sublattice morphism with the power set is the same thing than a relation. Well, we have the category of relation, we have Funder-F. Now, I want to define the automorphisms, the group, the locally group of automorphisms of an object and then of a functor. Okay? Then, for that, we consider, I want to do it this concretely. You see, I mean, there is an abuse of saying, well, locally group, we will talk about the locally group as if it were a group with elements and they will do, but this doesn't convince me. I mean, I want to just see how things are defined. So we need the notion of bijections with values in a locale. X and Y are two sets, we have a function in a locale G. Of course, if G is two, then we have a subset of X and Y, and then we have a relation. So a bijection is a relation, but with values in a locale, and then I have everywhere defined, univaluate, surjective, and injective, in the language, in this language of relations as maps from X, Y into G. So here you see the lambda X, Y means that in the relation, X is related to Y. So this means that there is a Y given X, there is a Y such that this is equal to 1. So that means that for every X, there is a Y such that the relation is defined of X and gives a Y. And then this is a univalued, let's see, injective, which is more, which just says that X is different from X prime, and then you cannot have a Y, which is, you cannot have X and Y that go to the same, X and X prime that go to the same Y. This is zero. So these four axioms characterize bijections with values in the locale. Now, here there is the idea. I have a set X. Now I can have rel X is the free locale on X times X. This is the universal relation. This map is the universal relation. This is a locale and well, and then a relation, if G is a universal relation, means that a relation like this, a relation into any other locale, extends uniquely into G, which is the free locale on X times Y, okay? Then this universal relation is just the free locale on X times X, and then we force the axioms of these relations to be a bijection, and then we define, at this point, I don't care how you construct out of X, but by definition, the locally group for automorphisms of X is a universal bijection. So this is the universal bijection. Think in sets, X is a set, okay? And then this out of X, which is the locale of open sets of the set of bijections of X with the product topology X with discrete topology. And then you can think of this as precisely a subbase of the product topology. You take all the bijections that in the point X pass by Y. It's just definition of subbase of product topology. So you can think of this as, this is done entirely in the language of relations, of sublattices. Now, there is a coalgebra structure in out of X, which is defined by matrix multiplication, okay? I can define W from X times X as the sup of X, of all Z of X, Z tensor ZY. And this actually, you can show, is a bijection. So I have here from x times x a bijection in this. Since this is the universal bijections, I have w here. So this here are the, we don't look at this diagram now because we have no time, is the antipode and the unit, okay? To have a real, this is only the co-multiplication, and here we have a coalgebra. This proposition don't look for the moment. Now, what is an action of G on X? Well, in the classical sense, an action of G on X is a morphing of groups from G into the group of automorphs of bijections of X. So here we are on the other side of the duality, then an action of G on X will be a local morphism from out from the universal bijection into G for any bijection mu. So an action is of G on X is a bijection with values in G such that satisfy the actions of action, which correspond to the fact that this mu is not only local morphisms but preserve also the coalgebra structure. Okay. So we know very well what are the actions of G in a set. They are just bijections with additional actions. The comodule, a comodule of G, because G is also a Hopf algebra, on a free lattices on Lx is just a linear map with the actions of comodule. Okay. Well, I will don't have time to talk about the morphisms. Now, what we want to prove is that a G action, an action of G on X, is exactly the same thing that a G comodule structure on L of X. Okay. This can be done. We do a little bit of linear algebra. The relation, if you have first a relation, a local morphisms from the monoid of relations, just local morphism to G, then you have this corresponds to a relation, taking the free L, it gives a linear map into G, and then by linear algebra, this corresponds to a linear map from L of X to G L of X. And we can check that if G is satisfied, if rho satisfies the G comodule actions, then mu satisfies the coalgebra morphisms actions. Okay? So if rho is a G comodule, then mu is coalgebra morphisms. Now, a coalgebra morphisms is actually a morphisms. Is also is a factors through the automorphisms. I mean, it's a coalgebra morphisms. What it's lacking to be a G actions that it goes out of the locally group of automorphisms. But the coalgebra corresponding to the fact that if you have a morphisms of monoids from a group into the monoid of endomorphisms of a set. This actually, since G is a group, they go all the elements go to isomorphisms. So this morphisms of a group into the monoid of endomorphisms actually takes values in the group, okay, of automorphisms. So this shows this last. Well, actually, you can do it in this language, this idea, and then this shows that a coalgebra morphisms actually takes factors through the group of automorphisms. Because you see, mu is a coalgebra, is a local morphism, but it preserves the coalgebra structure, then it factors through the automorphism. And we can see that relations also correspond, okay? This is. And so there is an we show the first theorem that there is an isomorphism of sublattice categories, so, I mean categories over the closed category of sublattices, between the category of relations of the classifying topos of G, or that means the topos of actions of G on discrete sets, and the comodule zero of G means the comodule structures on sublattices of the form L of X. Okay. Down here, relations, we have L. Relations is a full subcategory of sublattices, the category of sets with relations, okay? And then if we take SL0 are the relations with X, are the sublattices of the form L of X, which they have duals. This is not, we know, well, now they are self-dual. So it satisfies the general Tanaka assumptions. Then these isomorphisms live here. You see, here you have R is a relation correspond to a linear map. This is this. Now, this actually, this isomorphism lived here, meaning if R now is a relation in the category of G actions, meaning X and Y have an action of G, and then R is a, has an action of G, and this is a subobject here, then it corresponds to a comodule morphism between L of X and L of Y. Okay? So this is the first theorem that says that for any locally group or Hopf algebra, the category of sublattices, there is an equivalence between the categories of comodules of G seen as a Hopf algebra and the category of relations in the on the category of G actions of G, when we see G as a locally group. Okay. Now, locally Galois theory. Now, what I want is to define the automorphism, the Galois group of automorphisms of the functor F, of the point F. Then I define what will be a triangular cone. Cone is a local L furnished with relations phi of X from Fx into L for all X, but these relations are not only relations, there are bijections. So a triangular cone is a local furnished with bijections, and which for any map from X to X, the triangle commutes. And the automorphism of F is the universal triangular cone of bijections. This works, okay? I mean, this, you can define in this way the locally, we can see that the points of this locale, if it had, are just the bijections of X, because you see a point of out of F means local morphisms into two, is just a bijection between F of X and F of X. And the triangular, this triangular is saying that the bijection is natural. I mean, you just can sit down and check it. So the points of this are the automorphisms of F, but as we have seen in the in Galois theory, this set may have no points, if it are not finite. So this way we can construct directly the Galois group, the locally group of automorphisms of F, without doing all within the category of sublattices. Now, as this actually has, is not only local, but has a coalgebra structure, generalizing this matrix multiplication. We do it for each X and then it extends by the universal property. And then, we do this for each X, and then we show that there are triangular cones of bijections, so it induces by the universal property of F the respective arrows. And so it follows that this universal bijection is actually a locally group. And by the very definition, these injections are precisely bijections on the from the set F of X into this locally group, which are the definition of an action of out of F in the set F of X. Okay? So you have just this lifting from E into BG. Now a theorem that if C is a small a topos, a small generators, then it suffices to take consider delta cones over C. So this shows that this locally group exists if we have small generators. And in the theorem I say that I wanted to prove by hand the Joyal result was this one. If E is connected atomic and C are the site of connected generators, then F tilde is an equivalence. Okay? So this is the theorem which is true and proved in the Galois side. Now, Tanaka contest for Galois. Okay. Here, this works for any regular category, but think that it is just a topos if you want. We are working sets, it's the category of sets, it's not any arbitrary based topos. Now, this satisfied all the conditions in the Tanaka general. I mean, these conditions, if A is has itself, I mean, we have several conditions that gave you that the pre-dual, the pre-dual and nu of t is a commutative of algebra. Here all the hypotheses are satisfied. So we have this Joyal pre-dual is actually a Hopf algebra. So here we have already Hopf algebra. And now, because of the, as I was just saying, this is just an action of out of F on F of X, we have this lifting from of the point F into beta G, BG. And well, I will have this theorem. Now, the Tanaka context associated to a Galois context is the following. We have F, the functor F, from E into sets. Now, we have inclusion in the category of objects, and the maps are the relations. And downstairs we have the relations of sets, which is contained in sublattices. And this, what I just say, that this T satisfies all the conditions on the Tanaka general for this particular case. So N nu of T exists and is a Hopf algebra. And by, if you remember the definition of N nu of T, it was a coend. And then if we, the coend is just by definition a universal diamond cone, by definition of coend. So N nu of T is furnished, now here they are not bijections, it's just relations, and it's universal, given any locale which furnishes with relation, there exists a unique linear map. So N nu of T is defined as universal delta diamond cone of relations, while in the category of sublattices, while the automorphism group, locally group of G, is defined as the universal triangular cone of bijections in the category of locales. Okay? So what we are going to do is to prove that they are isomorphic locally groups or isomorphic Hopf algebras. So you see, well, we can prove that this universal property, the character nu of T, and this universal diamond code, and the universal delta triangular cone in the category of locales, and the diamond cone in the category of sublattices, are equivalent conditions for a local G. So the universal one is going to be the same here than there. Okay. Now I have prepared the hints of how you prove that, but I don't think I will stay long on this because time runs fast. Okay. Well, here is the same theorem than before. If we have generators, this large coend exists. Okay. Now, here's the proof that the automorphism group of F is the locality group of automorphisms of F is isomorphic to the pre-dual Hopf algebra of endomorphisms of T. I recall that this is, doesn't say not, it's a not, it's lacking an E. Okay, note that T is equal to F on E, okay? T of X, F of X, blah, blah. Well, anybody can ask me, and I gave you this is a copy of the PDF file with this. Here is the hints of how the proof goes. You have to prove that any delta cone defines a diamond cone, and any diamond cone defines a delta cone, okay? And look at the different categories. This is diamond cone in the category of sublattices, and this and the others are triangular cones in the category of locales. But you show that they are the same. So it can be checked that the isomorphisms, the localic isomorphic, the local morphisms, which is an isomorphism, also preserve all the algebraic structure other than local, I mean, preserve also the coalgebra structures, and there is an isomorphism of Hopf algebras. So we have the second theorem that say that given a point irregular category, well, let's say a topos, then the localic group of automorphisms of F is isomorphic to the pre-dual Hopf algebra of endomorphisms of T. Okay? Where T is F actually, but it's defined on relations. It's the extension of F to relations. Well, here I'm using relation for the actual relation subset of X and also the word relation with arrows into a local. Okay? So we have this diagram. Here we have E with the pointed. Then we take relation of E and extend F to relations. F preserves finite limits, so it extends easily to relations. We have T. Now, the theorem one shows that the relation of the classifying topos of G are this isomorphic to the comodules of G thought as a Hopf algebra. We have an isomorphism here. And which we just proved is that G, the automorphism, locality group of automorphisms of G, is isomorphic to the Hopf algebra of pre-dual endomorphisms of T. So these two categories are isomorphic by this second theorem. Now, we have that if F hat, the leaf unit of F, is an isomorphism, is an equivalence, it follows easily that the relation is an equivalence. So since this diagram commutes and these two are equivalents, we have that F hat is an equivalent if and only if T hat is an equivalence. T hat is the lifting, is the what we want in Tanaka theory to show that it's an equivalence, and F hat is what we want in Galois to show that it's an equivalence. So it follows that F hat is an equivalence if and only if T hat is an equivalence, okay? So in that sense, we prove this recognition Tanaka theorem that this category of relation of E is equivalent to the category of comodules. Now, this is not everything we want, because we want to characterize this in relation of E. We want to put any SL category satisfying certain conditions. So we say that if A is an SL category satisfying certain conditions, then we have that T hat is an equivalence. We have what is called a Tanaka recognition theorem. Okay, and this is known in the literature, a characterization of the categories, SL categories of relations, which are, there is a paper of Andrew Pitts which works on results of Walters and Carboni, which says that the category, SL category is a category of relations of a topos, if and only if it's a bounded, complete, distributed category of relation. This is all in the language of sublattice categories. And so we have the theorem B that says that EA is a bounded, complete, distributed category lattice, which is complete and atomic. This is said in the language of also of sublattice categories, furnishes with a point which is open and faithful, then T hat is an equivalence, because all this hypothesis says that T is, that A is the category of relations of an atomic topos. And here we have the Galois theorem, theorem A. This theorem is proved. This theorem, we have proved this theorem using this one by this equivalence, okay? So this is the, if you look at the generalization of Tanaka theory, we have the original Tanaka theorem by Deligne on vector spaces. And all the generalization of Tanaka theory for another monoidal closed categories use the fact that the functor into sets, which is homing in with the, in the first coordinate, the neutral object, I mean, the underline, preserve filtered colimits. So it's an essential in any theorem that generalizes Deligne, and also in the Deligne theorem, he used implicitly or explicitly that the object, neutral object, is of finite presentation, which means that preserve filtered colimits. This is not the case in the, for sublattices. So actually, this is the only known Tanaka recognition theorems for a closed category in which the object, neutral object, is not a finite presentation. All the other ones are. So since the proof of Deligne heavily used the fact that the object I is a finite presentation, the proof in the for sublattices has to be different. Okay? Now we have a proof for sublattices because we show that this theorem is equivalent to the Galois. But Joyal say, well, it will be interesting to prove theorem B, so we can have theorem A out of theorem B. Okay, so, but I have no idea how to prove it, and actually I have not. You see, this subject is very interesting, nice, but it has a problem. We had, with my student, now is a colleague, Martin Schild, that we did this work, also generalized the general Deligne theorem, not neutral Tanaka, but the general Tanaka, with Royal Tierney characteristic that shows that every topos are the actions of a locally groupoid. And we proved the equivalence of these two things. And this was much harder. We had to work over arbitrary based topos, and all proofs are, well, it was very much difficult. We wrote a paper and sent it to the same place, to the Advances. This, what I talked today, it was published in the Advances with no problem. Now we send a paper much more difficult, which is the general case, to the same editor, to the Advances. For us, it was a much more important paper. They did not accept it because they said the audience is going to be very small. But we are happy to accept this, the editor say, if you send it to TAC, because it has more specialized thing, you see. So we say, okay, it was published in TAC. But then you see, why do we really want to spend a lot of effort to work in something that is out of fashion, in a way, you see? This is a problem when you have to decide. The problems are only interested, but if you become really interested in a problem which is more in fashion, it's better, in a way, okay? In a way, mathematics evolves following a central arrow. And then sometimes problems are equally interesting, but in branches that you are leaving a little bit the central arrow. And I think that today, I hope that this is an interesting thing to know, how the Galois and Tanaka are related. But category theory is evolved more in the fact of a higher category theory and well, the hot that we have seen in this lecture and things like that. So I hope that you enjoyed this as it's a nice piece of work. And it was concrete, it was central enough to be accepted in the Advances. But if we have the general case, which is much deeper theorem, then this is only for TAC. So, well, I actually finish 5 minutes less than what I had allowed.
We can ask a question.
Yes, no, because we start 5 minutes afterwards.
Yes, if you want.
Well, okay. Well, this is finished, you see. I don't.